Here at home, Malacanang touts the composition of the new Bangsamoro Transition Authority for including representatives of the Moro National Liberation Front, aside from the Moro Islamic Liberation Front. Now, among the new members, the children of MNLF Chairman and Founder Nur Miswari, Abdul Karim, and Nurheda Miswari. Now, Press Secretary Trixie Angeles says this is an indication that the two former Moro rebel groups are heeding the call for unity of Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Presidential Peace Advisor Secretary Carlito Galvez Jr. also lauded the inclusion of the MNLF in the BTA. The BTA is an interim government in the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao under the Bangsamoro Organic Law. The BOL specifies that the MILF shall lead the BTA, making up 41 of the 80-member body. The remaining 39 members are endorsed by the government.
President Marcos says the country might import 100,000 metric tons of sugar in October, but local supply falls. In his YouTube vlog, Marcos said that amount may already augment sugar supply in the country for the whole year. That's smaller than 300,000 metric tons previously proposed. He adds government cannot do away with importation right now as it addresses productivity issues in the agriculture sector. Last week, Marcos rejected a proposal to import more sugar, with the palace saying the resolution was illegally signed. Former Agriculture Undersecretary Leocadio Sebastian, who signed the order on behalf of Marcos without his consent, has already resigned from his post.
Another senator has filed a resolution urging the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee to conduct a probe on the purchase of allegedly overpriced and outdated laptops for public school teachers. Now, in particular, Senator Alan Peter Cayetano wants to know what caused the delay in the procurement of the laptops. He said having the Bayanihan 2 law at that time should have made the process easier or faster. Senators from the minority bloc, Coco Pimentel and Risa Ontiveros, have also filed a resolution seeking an investigation on the matter. It was the Commission on Audit which first flagged the 2.4 billion peso purchase of the outdated laptops. They were supposed to be used by teachers for the implementation of distance learning during the height of the COVID-19 pandemic. The Education Department has said it is open to any probe and that it is already looking at the possibility of replacing the laptops. In Taiwan, where another U.S. congressional delegation has arrived, the five-member delegation led by Democratic Senator Ed Markey will meet with Taiwanese President Tsai Ing-wen and attend a banquet hosted by Foreign Minister Joseph Yu. The American Institute in Taiwan says the two sides will be discussing issues of mutual interest, including global supply chains and regional security. Now, Sunday's unannounced trip came after U.S. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi visited the island nation earlier this month, sparking unprecedented air and sea drills by China that raised the prospect of conflict. Taiwan accused China of using Pelosi's visit as an excuse to kickstart military exercises to rehearse for an invasion. China views Taiwan as its own territory to be taken one day by force if necessary.
China again responding angrily to the latest Taiwan visit. In a commentary, state news agency Xinhua accused the visiting American lawmakers of being opportunists, thinking about their own political interests as November's midterm elections draw near. The agency adds the U.S. politicians are playing with fire on the Taiwan question, stressing that there is no room for compromise or concessions when it comes to Beijing's core interests. For China's embassy in Washington, it says this latest development once again proves the U.S. does not want stability in the Taiwan Strait. In its daily update, Taiwan's defense ministry said it had detected 22 Chinese planes and 6 ships operating around the strait Sunday. Of those, 11 planes crossed the median lane, an unofficial demarcation between Taiwan and China that Beijing does not recognize.